I can guarantee you that if you find a spider in your house or in your backyard, you can pick it up, you can play with it, you can put it in your sister's hair, and while you might get in trouble, it's not gonna pose any danger to you or her. I might be a little worried about the spider though. It's been said that the weight of insects consumed annually by spiders exceeds the weight of the human population of the world. People have a very poor perception of insects and arachnids in our culture, and it's unfortunate because all terrestrial ecosystems depend on insects and spiders in order to work properly. About 80% of the plants in Edmonton are pollinated by insects, so if even the nuisance insects aren't around, we would be short a lot of plants in the Edmonton area. Really, just about any sort of flying insect that would land in a flower is potentially a pollinator. So things like flies and wasps and mosquitoes that we wouldn't necessarily think of as being helpful or important do have an important role as a pollinator. Ants are an insect that many Edmontonians end up having issues with. In many cases, this is simply because the ants end up entering people's houses looking for food. They work a little like little Roomba robots where they bumble along the edge of the surface, and if there happens to be a hole there, they get in. And they leave a little scent trail behind them, like Hansel and Gretel leaving breadcrumbs. So if they find a food source, all they have to do is follow that scent trail back, and then other ants from the colony can come in and exploit that food source too. Considering the importance of insects in general ecosystems, I'd certainly like to think of them more as friends and neighbors and helpers rather than just pests.